A hungry, hungry black hole. So big, it's eating one of our suns a day. I'm Matt Miller. You're watching Trekzone, and this is a Talkin' Science Story of the Week.
With the latest science and space news 5 days a week across Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, and YouTube, this is Talkin' Science with Dr. Brad Tucker and Matt Miller.
And Brad, as we do each and every week, three stories to fill up our show, fill up our goodness of science news and space news as well. And this one has me really, really worried. A black hole that's eating a sun a day. What have you done to me, Brad? Why have you given me nightmares?
Because it's 2020 and it's July, so...
Something has to happen.
Something has to happen. No, luckily this is not a disaster that we'll have anytime soon, you know, maybe in 20 billion years. So this is a very massive black hole. So this black hole is 34 billion times the mass of our sun. So to put this in the scale, the supermassive black hole in our galaxy, what we call Sagittarius A star, is 4 million times the mass of our sun. This thing is 34 billion times the mass of our sun. And because it's so big and the gravity and what we call the accretion disk, the gas and stars spinning around it, it's literally sucking in about a sun a day in terms of stuff.
Now, that there's some scale involved here. As you're saying, it's almost 30 billion times bigger than even the black hole of our galaxy. So the universe is huge.
That's right. Exactly. You know, and so this is really a monster black hole. And it's far away. It's 12 billion light years away, which is always good. You like it. You want a nice buffer zone between you and the monster black hole. I think the really interesting thing here is one of the big studies or goals that we're trying to do is to figure out how big and how fast black holes can get. So essentially, how big can they grow? Now, as we look backwards in time, you know, the universe is smaller, things are younger, takes more time for things to grow. So how do you get something that big that early?
And the black hole is called J2157. It was found, funnily enough, like you think of black holes and you think of against the inky blackness of space, how do these things get found? And this one was found by its really bright ultraviolet light. So we don't want to get close to it, aside from the fact we'll get sucked in, but we'll also get bombarded with UV radiation.
Exactly. You know, and this is how we find it, is we find less of the black hole itself, but of the feeding frenzy. So, you know, it's kind of like a dog, or especially a beagle. you don't see the food go into the mouth ever. You just see the evidence and the destruction left behind. And that's exactly what the black hole is. You don't want to see into it, but you know things go into it.
Now, if we had this monster sitting at the center of the Milky Way galaxy, it'd appear 10 times brighter than a full moon. Again, we're coming back to this scale. It's just incredible. And really hard to fathom.
Look, it really is. And it just shows you the range and how powerful these things can get, especially black holes.
And I do wonder, is there enough material to keep feeding this monster? Or what's going to happen when it starts getting hungry?
We know black holes go through periods of feeding, essentially, that they feed more, they feed less. And it all depends on how much stuff is around and how quickly it can swallow it. You know, black holes do have a limit. So when we try and find these big black holes and what we call quasars, so very active galaxies dominated by a black hole, the question is how do they get that big that fast? You know, and this one is really defying belief of how getting that big that fast when the universe was only 10% its age. And so that's the question, is how long can it keep this process up?
Well, Brad, those questions will remain unanswered for a little while. Hopefully we find out eventually before it becomes a threat to us. But this has been a Talkin' Science Story of the Week, and looking forward to another one tomorrow.
Sounds good.